So this thumbnail was made by this guy, Derogue, and he wanted me to say that there is a headless body at this location.
So, here's the thing. I fucking hate Trump.
So the YouTube algorithm gets a lot of shit every now and then, probably for promoting stupid shit like the terrible YouTube shorts. And I tend to get a bit of weird stuff on my YouTube recommended feed too. YouTube's always had this thing where about half of the things recommended to me are videos that I probably don't even care for, and on a surface level, I really don't care for much of it, and would scroll past it. Except for this one, this is actually good. But one day I was scrolling on YouTube as usual, when I came across a specific video from a specific channel, and upon clicking this video, I was met with the cancer-inducing abomination known as the Discord notification sound effect. Except this time, the notification sound effect didn't come from my computer, it came from the video, and was spammed the shit out of. Lo and behold, I was met with oversimplified thumbnails and titles that probably appealed to 6th graders who make a gorgillion unfunny big chungus jokes in a day. Now who might this person be, you're probably asking? Who might the owner of the channel really be? Well, it's none other than the king of 9-year-old Discord kids himself, Beluga.
I just don't get it. I always catch you fuckers watching this sick shit.
Now, I know that 99% of people probably know who this individual is, probably because his crack-ass videos incessantly come up in your recommendations. Speaking of which, these videos are some of the most god-awfully unfunniest abominations to ever disgrace YouTube.com. Now, I don't know about you, but if I actually see one of these videos refer to a hacker as hecker or a teacher as tetcher, then I'm gonna cause a resonance cascade. I'm not joking, I know G-Man.
Really, that time again. It seems as if
I can suck your dick.
And it gets worse when you find out that the pain isn't only visual, but also takes place in the form of audio. That's right. Remember the Discord notification sound I mentioned a short while ago? Well, let's elaborate on it. Imagine you live next to 5 wind turbines that constantly spam a loud and obnoxious noise in your ear the entirety of the duration of time that you choose to remain in that area. Well, take that and amplify the annoyance by a million times. That's basically the impression I get from seeing one of Beluga's videos. The shit is spammed so often to the point of annoyance that the only people weeded out who find this funny are children who think that loud and obnoxious noises are equal to humor at all times. Again, this obviously ties to the point of oversimplification, mainly due to his 9-year-old fans presuming that using the Discord notification sound on an overwhelmingly repeated basis is now the pinnacle of comedy. Now fine, I get it, comedy is subjective, but when all your comedic appeal is repeatedly oversimplified on every video, it has the effect of doing the exact opposite, and actually makes most of his videos seem like an incessant barrage of obnoxious garbage. Anyways, I'm not one to bully kids on the internet, but from what I'm seeing, Beluga's fanbase consists of primarily two types of people. One, unfunny 14-year-old band kids who base their lives off of Reddit and Discord, and two, 8-year-olds who find his unfunny and repetitive Discord videos to be actually funny because of the amount of incessant, repeated, and overused jokes. Now, from this, it's pretty obvious that when these two forces are combined, they create a dedicated viewer base that will unconditionally and mindlessly watch videos endlessly, essentially giving Beluga a shit ton of views and subscribers. And from what I see, people act like this guy is the new algorithm breaker and shit, but let me tell you, he's far from that. Actually, before I go on an unhinged Alex Jones level rant, let's check a few videos to see what he's really done.
How Beluga gained 4 million subscribers in 3 months. How Beluga broke YouTube. How Beluga destroyed YouTube's algorithm.
Shut the fuck up!
Now, as you can see, these are some pretty hefty things to say, but what if I told you that Beluga's so-called algorithm cracking is no more than artificially kickstarting a channel and spamming it with oversimplified content that mindless fetuses are going to evidently watch? Well, that's exactly what it is, and give me a moment to explain. Beluga's channel was actually endlessly promoted by an older channel he had with almost a million subscribers, and after he got that initial viewer base from relentlessly advertising on that older channel, he started uploading videos with what some would call catchy and cliffhanging titles and thumbnails that would get his viewers to keep clicking.
This wasn't Beluga's first channel. In fact, his YouTube journey had actually began in 2019, when he launched a channel about lucid dreaming. After growing this channel to almost 1 million subscribers, it was clear Beluga wanted a new challenge. He decided to go all in on cross-promotion. He mentioned and linked his new channel at every opportunity. He also made community posts about it and even funneled traffic to his Beluga videos through end screens.
Now, I don't know about you, but that's not cracking the algorithm. And I always see these
ex-YouTuber broke the algorithm videos.
And yeah, no, other than the fact that the phrase cracking the algorithm is a practical buzzword of a circle jerk to trick new and small YouTubers into thinking that they actually have a chance in becoming the next PewDiePie if they just do what these algorithm crackers, and in our case, Beluga, did. Now, what does this have to do with Beluga? Well, little to nothing. And with that, I think I'll end this video off saying that Beluga's videos are overrated piles of shit that rely on regurgitated and bland jokes enjoyed by unfunny prepubescent children.